are pulling out all of our biggest predictions for this season. It happens every year. It's called Prediction Week. This is Prediction Week 2020. Yes, for our first prediction here, it's very serious. We take it, you know, this is big time. We have to stew over this. We also don't talk about it with each other. We have no idea who each other is going to pick. So we'll do offensive and defensive rookies of the year. Let's start things off on the offensive side of the ball. We'll go around the table. Shregs, you are up.
All right, five quarterbacks were taken in the first round. I would argue no quarterback went to a better situation and went to a better place than the guy in my teleprompter right now.
That's my prediction, Peter.
Yep. You can only say it so many times,
Kyle. You saw
it
coming.
I got my first prediction right.
Yes, you did.
I'm
yes,
one for
did.
One. Go ahead, Peter. Who are you going with?
Oh, we got it. Mac Jones is my offense.
Oh, awesome.
I think Mac Jones is going to be outstanding in this offense from day one. No one is joining a better situation where there are skill positions that were added. They spent about $180 million on the offense this offseason to give him two tight ends, two wide receivers, a rebuilt offensive line. And, oh, yeah, he goes to a team that has Bill Belichick and Josh McDaniels in his corner. He's the starting quarterback. He's number one from go. I think he's going to roll out, and they are going to be successful this season. If you believe in the Patriots with Mac Jones, you have to think that this team is going to win some games, and they like to vote Rookie of the Year to the guys who have the most team success as well as individual numbers.
Yeah.
I think Mac Jones is going to be the offensive rookie of the year as long as he stays healthy and as long as he does what they expect him to do. Mac Jones, I see a fifth quarterback taken, but first in my rookie of the year
predictions. I love it. Mike, you're going to go next.
Yeah, I like that Mac Jones pick. I'm going to stick with the quarterbacks. I'm going to go with Zach Wilson in New York.
Okay.
Yeah,
nice.
Not so sure he's going to have the best team success or better success than out there in New England, but I do think he'll play better. The arm talent, guys, you just can't overlook that. The arm angles, the different off-platform throws that this kid makes. And I love the offense that he's in, too, that Mike LaFleur offense. Very QB-friendly. They're going to try to run the football. They have a massive offensive line who's very capable of blocking guys in front of him. And this kid has shown in the preseason that he can handle the throws. It's not too big for him. Look at that throw right there. I just want him to make the best decisions possible in every single play. And I think if he does that, he's going to have a great rookie season that ends with the offensive rookie of the year.
Wow.
Yeah. It's pretty cool because, you know, don't necessarily think they got to get to the playoffs. Justin Herbert last year, Kyler Murray the year before, offensive rookies of the year. Is it my turn?
Yeah.
All right, so we got all these great quarterbacks. And I'm going to pick the only one in the first round who's not going to start and not going to play this weekend. I'm going with Justin Fields. I think it's going to happen. I'm not joking. I'm not doing shtick. I think this Andy Dalton thing will be remedied very quickly. And I think Justin Fields is going to be a sensation.
You think he takes over in week one?
Maybe in the middle of the game.
Really?
And if it's not week one, I think it'll be week two. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's a freezing cold take. Maybe he doesn't play a snap. I don't think so. I think this is going to be Deshaun Watson the second he hits the field. It's going to be Mr. 7A. We're going to talk. He's going to be one of the biggest stories of the year. I believe in him that much. I know the Dalton thing is messy, and he's going to have to be incredible to get a late start behind some of these guys. He will be. I'm going Justin Fields, totally unironically, dead serious, number one Chicago Bears offense rookie.
You know what, Kyle? Justin Fields, I mean, that offensive line is terrible. I don't mean to talk about squad like that.
Spicy.
But they're
Ramsey
quad. And his movement ability will help the offensive line. It'll help the run game and help all of that. Again, I've said it before. This kid would have to play himself out of the starting job if I was Matt Nagy.
Okay, so he thinks middle of the game, week one or week two. Peter and I are very much on the same. Like, okay, week five, week six. Like, Dalton's going to play a handful of games. Where do you stand?
I think about week four or five,
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think they'll give him some time. Mm-hmm. I think they will.
Don't
That's
cry.
You're
offensive rookie of the year. I'm going to go with a non-quarterback. I'm going to go with the physically the most gifted and talented person who was drafted this past year, Najee Harris. That's exactly where I'm going. I know there's questions about the offensive line with the Steelers, but there's just some talent that you kind of, it transcends. It's okay. And we saw it in the preseason. Look at what he did. It was incredible on the ground. He's got the bruising running style. And he's a natural receiver. He talks about it a lot. He's going to be used in that Le'Veon Bell sort of way. Look at, I just can't wait to see this happen. So this is a kid that you cannot take out of the game no matter what you do. No matter how bad your offensive line is, no matter what the defense has planned, he'll be all over it every week. So I think he's got a great shot at offensive line.
And Big Ben will check the ball down. He's one of those guys that will check it down and get it to the back. Guys, Don't overlook that guard out in Kansas City.
Trey Smith, sixth round pick.
I'm telling you, watch him on tape.
A sixth round pick is a road grader.
I think he's
okay. I'm just saying, keep your eyes on.
We don't mention confidence. We don't mention confidence. We talk Trey Smith.
Not Trey Lance. Trey Smith.
I'm just saying.
I
love man.
It. I got to know a little bit. I did the sideline for the preseason. He was the at all anyone talk. I just love that you just brought him
up. I'm just saying.
Didn't you do a whole segment on him?
I did. I wouldn't pick an offensive guard to be rookie of the year.
I'm just saying, keep your eyes on him, man.
Defensive rookie of the year predictions, and you guys can, of course, hit us up at GMFB. Let us know what you think, and let's do the same order. Shregs, who you got?
All right, I'm not going with a first-round pick. I'm going with a second-round pick for my defensive rookie of the year, and it's Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoa.
Hey, now.
The Cleveland Browns. He's going to be wearing number 28 for the team. And I think he's going to play a huge role in this defense. We know up front what they've got already, and we talked about Clowney and Garrett on the outsides. And then, of course, on the defensive backfield, they loaded up with John Johnson and Greg Newsome and Troy Hill. But this guy's a heat-seeking missile, and he's wearing 28.
That's what I'm about to say. He's 28?
28, which is it's so misleading because you're seeing 56 or 55 for your linebacker. 28 is going to be all over the field for the Cleveland Browns. I think the Browns are going to be outstanding this season, and I think their linebacker, Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoa, will be the defensive rookie of the year.
Is this the first time in Good Morning Football history that two people picked the same person?
Are you going the same way?
I'm going
Let's go!
He's explosive. He's quick. His preseason tape is absolutely insane. Everything that we've seen so far. This, you know, we're talking Trey Smith and his value defensively. Was there a better value in this draft than taking him in the second round? So I think Cleveland got a steal. I think he is the defensive rookie of the year. I don't think we've ever picked the same person.
Oh, my goodness.
It's awesome.
All right, let's go. Mike Robb next.
No, that is awesome because I can see a quarterback looking at the line of scrimmage and really not knowing how to identify that kid. Is he a DB? Is he a linebacker? Yes. Does the offensive line take him? I'm going to go with Michael Parsons. I don't care if you think it's a homer pick because he went to Penn State or whatever. The dude is probably going to be the best defensive rookie in the National Football League. The dude is a playmaker. He's a run-seeking heat missile, whatever you want to say.
A heat-seeking missile.
There you go. I said the words a little bit mixed up.
I liked yours.
He's going to be able to rush the passer. They're going to put him in a position called the Leo, right, which is kind of a DN, kind of an outside linebacker position at times. He's going to be able to rush the passer. He can cover backs and tight ends out of the backfield. And when he gets to you in a violent way. He's a franchise personality. I'm telling you, this kid is going to take the league by storm. Michael Parsons, 2021 Defensive Rookie of the Year.
I love it.
We're going to talk a lot about him this week. He got a game Thursday night,
yes,
man.
He does.
Like, he's got to go against Hall of Famers on the road. I can't wait to watch him. You know what I love watching? I love corners who come flying out of the gates. Marcus Peters won Defensive Player of the Year. Yep. Then you got to go back to Charles Woodson, and then you got to go clear into the 80s. And I think it's going to be 2021 in the Denver Broncos. Patrick Surtain.
Let's go.
Patrick Surtain. The way you get this award, the way you get any award as a corner, you got to have picks. You can't have passes defense. You can't have good cut. You got to get picks. Ball hawk, guys. Ball hawk. And let me just say one thing. It's time now. The season is starting. To all broadcasters, to all media members, it's Surtain. It's the professional. I know it looks like Surtain. I get it. It's tricky. But if these guys can say Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoa, whatever the hell it is, you can say Patrick Surtain. And I think that name will be said when they announce the Defensive Rookie of the Year with all they got going there in Denver. I think they chose the conservative route with Teddy Bridgewater, which means they're like, defense, get us home. Surtain, grab that thing and go. Patrick Surtain Jr. or the second, whichever you prefer, Defensive Rookie of the Year.
Well, let's take a look at all of our picks. We're talking Offensive Defensive Rookie of the Year. These are our predictions at the breakfast table for this year, which kicks off three sleeps right here on NFL Network between the Cowboys and the Buccaneers. Who did we miss? Who did we get wrong? We got three quarterbacks and a running back, and we've got some, you know, interesting defensive options.
I like that
class. Yeah,
I know I need a new headshot, man.